I usually set the advertisement up after I go live.
No, I know, but I was putting it together, like, while you were out of here, and I'm almost done. I just haven't sent them out yet. So, I'm going live just so that it is actually running, so people aren't thinking, like, well, if it's running, then why the hell isn't it up yet?
Yeah, I get it. Is it just going to be you and me on the commentary team?
We might get Blue and we might get JC back later. JC is feeling under the weather, so I don't think he'll be joining us.
Well, Blue's in the streamer chat.
Pull him in if you can.
Alright.
I'd appreciate it.
There we go.
Here we go. Hey, dude.
Hey.
Yeah, just going live so that people have the chance to at least get in.
You want to take some sucker shots at my banana cage, Bilbo?
20-month subversary. 20-month subversary after a 20-day hiatus. And no, I'm not stoned. My tongue's just tied in a knot. And hey, Magnus. Holy hell, Rock. What? Tex and Blue sound really loud compared to you. Yeah, that's probably Discord. For me. Just give me a sec. I'll adjust them.
Are we really that loud?
You might be louder than me.
Hang on.
Sometimes it does sound like you're whispering.
No, it's on my... It's on my... It like, that's on my end. The microphone thing, I'm not so sure about.
Okay.
That might be because my... No, my mic audio says I should be at the right amount. Huh. Might also be because the desktop audio is at, like, maximum. So I might have to adjust that, too, when we actually get into the show. Like, how loud are you guys on stream? Like...
I have no idea.
I don't know. You sound fine on my end. I don't know. Hang on.
I'm not sure how I sound either.
No, you guys are louder than I am. But, I don't know if that's because of Discord, or if the microphone itself, its maximum output only goes so high. I don't know. It doesn't matter.
Weird.
It can't be that big of a deal. It's something that we could more than likely work on. The only other thing I could think of is, let me see here, maybe if I open Audacity and take a look at my... microphone.
I'm on Twitch right now.
Yeah, I know. I'm talking about on my end, where people are saying that my microphone sounds, like, lower than it should be. So, the recording level is down, so I'm gonna turn it up in Audacity and see if that does anything for the, volume. If you guys could, like, confirm that for me, Stormy, or anybody.
Okay.
They're not that loud, Stormy.
Okay.
At least I don't think so. They're not that loud. Yeah, they're fine.
Yeah, XPWL, but yet your stream says you're playing Warframe.
Yeah. Oh, for crying out loud. Here we go again.
Here we go again.
Give me a second, stupid.
Yay, we're back to stream issues.
Hey, what's a stream without issues?
Yeah, tell me about it. Ugh. Just give me a second here, guys. I'm just making the quick adjustments while we're on stream. Yay!
Don't worry.
Okay, there. That should fix that issue anyway. We haven't even started the show anyway, so I'm not going to worry about it. There we go.
Yes, it's
JC can watch if he wants to, Stormy. He said he was going to watch on his phone or whatever. So, you know what? I'm not worried about that. Also, just realized.
Yeah. Just get better soon, mate.
Yeah. Did I not send these out? No, I didn't. Wow. You're really on the ball today, Rockadile. Dumbass. Dumas.
Dumas.
So all I need is Rammstein to start fucking playing in the background. Dumas.
Shoot.
Thank you.
Yeah. Like I said, I hope you get better. Anyway, just give me a second here. I'm gonna go take these bear trap jaws of mine and scare the shit out of Mark.
Ain't out loud.
Yeah!
You ever have the feeling we...
Anybody got some antiseptic and some medical gauze? Ow!
Not on me. All I got's a can of alcohol. You want that?
Yeah, give me that. That's not...
Well, yeah.
That's not stuff to clean wounds. That's a beer! Damn it, Bruce!
Hey, you drink enough of it. Hey, you drink enough of that shit, you won't feel any pain. Trust me, I've been through a lot of barbed wire matches.
Oh, you know what? The hell with it this time. You know what? You guys can call the first match. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to XBWL Saturday Night Slam Masters. I am here alongside from the YWL, Jim Johnston.
Hello.
From ACW, Bruce Northaway.
Hi.
And of course, your lead commentator here, who is in an incredible amount of pain, Mark Wundersham. Now, give me that beer. Guys, just announce the first match.
All right. The first match we're going to be having here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, is Brody Harper against Conquest. Oh, it's been a while since I've seen Brody.
That's fake. You're all familiar with these guys. You do the bloody ring announcements.
I can do this one. I just needed a second to shotgun that beer. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, this is your opening contest for XBWL Saturday Night Slam Masters, and it is scheduled for one fall. This match will be contested with no countouts. Currently on his way to the ring from Darkseid, he is the right hand of the Shepherd, Brody Harper!
This could go interesting either way.
I've also got to wonder if this was kind of premeditated. Think about this. Brody is going into the ring with one of the horsemen, and we all know there's a problem between the Pale Rider and the Shepherd.
Oh, yeah. I've heard about that.
The Shepherd going. I haven't seen him backstage in ECW for weeks now.
Last time I saw him, he was freaking hiding somewhere in the back, just kind of wrenching back and forth on his phone, sitting down in the corner somewhere near the production truck. Ever since he lost that lantern, it's like he's been completely coming unhinged.
Well,
hey, Dustin.
Well, yeah, I imagine.
Brody's opponent from the Golden Halls of Victorum. He is one of the four horsemen. This is Conquest. If I didn't know any better, I'd say he is mocking Brody on his way out here.
You should not mock Brody Harper. That's gonna leave you with a broken everything.
Possibly, but I think Conquest might be built a little bit harder than he is. Brody better be careful. Conquest is not somebody you can just shove off.
Oh, that I know. Nevertheless, Conquest stepping into the ring now. He is intimidating already.
The four horsemen of the apocalypse have got their hands full by the looks of it with at least Shepherd and Brody Harper here. I'm a little surprised. Yeah, Shepherd's not out here, but Brody is. Hey, Ron.
And that guy intimidating, he looks like a friggin' cheap bloody King Arthur cosplay.
Maybe not. You'd have to see him in the ring to understand, Bruce. Nice suplex by Brody right off the bat here, and he is wasting no time.
Brody already showing the aggression.
Trying to maul him. Conquest is dealing with a monstrous human being from the bayou.
Well, he wrestles alligators, that's for certain.
If he gets that gator roll locked in, that could be pretty bad.
And Conquest already going for shots.
And headbutt.
You're not winning many fans with your descriptions of people, Bruce. Oh, God. Man. Conquest clubbing the hell out of Brody. Brody trying to get back up, but he just can't do it.
Hey, you know what I'm like?
Conquest going up to the top rope. What's he going for here? Oh. Elbow right onto the spine.
And Brody rolled over here. One. Whoa.
Only a one. That was quick.
The ref was a bit hesitant on that one count.
Wild kick there. Double leg drop.
Make a wish.
Whoa.
And a leg toss.
Just mauling Brody all around the ring here.
Conquest is aiming for the legs.
Probably the best thing he can do, take Brody's vertical base away from him. He's not going to be able to pull off those power moves. And he sure as hell isn't going to have a lot of oomph on that discus clothesline if he can't actually stand up. Oh, my God.
And Conquest showing the strength. It's a lot of blood going up to your head.
Irish whip to the corner.
Oh!
And no, oh, big boot.
Caught him right square in the jaw. That might be it. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Yeah, big difference in that kick out on that one. Brody didn't know what hit him. Conquest again going up top. That's a hell of a jump to make.
Way too far.
Nope.
Well, four better.
Decided against it after Brody was getting back up.
Quick knee smash, and again hurling Brody across the ring by his leg.
Stomp to the face.
Uh-oh.
And deadlift.
Sit out.
A power bomb.
Good God.
Brody has been in trouble the majority of this match.
Clubbed him in the head, and Brody wisely makes the quick retreat. But Conquest is going up top again. Oh, God. Oh!
Uh-oh. Oh, jeez.
How the hell did Conquest not hurt his legs on the way down there? He hit the apron on the way down.
I think he's going to have Brody to see a medical team after this match.
Michinoku
body
driver.
Slam.
Conquest lifts up Brody, and
busting him open.
Right across the LED screen, and yeah, there's a cut.
We got Keller.
Backbreaker, a second one.
And just tosses him like yesterday's newspaper.
Yeah, Brody's in deep trouble here. Ooh. Conquest focusing on his legs and now that busted open spot. Oh, God.
And the strength again.
Lifting Brody up onto the up into the air and down on the mats.
Slams him down onto the floor.
Another... I can't help but get in the fucking ring.
Well, they did so. Conquest is just circling around him, though.
Brody's in deep trouble here. He's holding his chest before he got back up. Oh!
No!
Maybe
never mind!
Maybe he played possum on this one. Oh! Oh! Holy
shit!
Almost took his head off. One, two, and Conquest still able to kick out.
Well, I was about to say, check the fourth row for Conquest's head on that one.
Look at the side of Brody's face. He is a mess. Oh, elbow drop.
No.
And Conquest taking a bit of a powder here. And Brody, oh my God, suicide dive. Right in front of us. That's the thing about it, JC. You got to remember, when Brody winds up that discus clothesline, he can hit you at any point with it.
Now it looks like the tides have turned.
I think rage is starting to set in. Remember, we know for a fact that Brody's a lot more dangerous when he gets angry. Yeah. And I mean like reckless dangerous. I'm not talking dangerous as in intimidating. I mean dangerous, like willing to do really crazy shit to win the match. Uh-oh. Gut wrench, suplex.
I've seen a lot of those lately.
Oh, running big boot. That is true, JC. I do remember you did take that flush. One, two. Brody not able to secure the pin, and he's getting angrier.
Well, measuring him up.
He hits this. It's over. Oh,
two.
Spinning lariat.
One, two. That's it.
And Brody finally getting the victory.
I gotta tell you that Brody's gotta have a ridiculous amount of force behind that clothesline.
Probably.
Because again, Conquest kicked out of it the first time pretty easily. I think Brody had to put everything into that one just to keep him down.
More than likely.
Let's get the official word.
Here is your winner, Brody Harper! And yeah, Brody, like I said, the one side of his head, he is a mess.
Did this for the Shepherd.
Oh, no doubt, but we don't even know where the Shepherd is right now.
He's probably in hiding trying to think of a game plan or something.
Maybe so. I have no idea. I'm going to be completely honest. I have no idea what we're going to expect. Like I said, Shepherd, he's still active, but I have no idea what the hell is going through his head right now, and that can be scary.
I'm kidding.
Of course.
Also, the next match is going to be a doozy anyway. Fair, thank you. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're getting ready to go down to the ring. This next match is going to determine one of the two last remaining slots in the XPWL Women's World Title Tournament that's coming up. We've got a brand new championship coming out soon. Like I said, the brand new Women's Championship being determined in this tournament, but we've still got to fill the last two slots. We've got two matches tonight to determine that, and we're going to be starting with the first one right now.
Oh boy.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is a qualifier for the XPWL Women's Championship Tournament, and it is scheduled for one fall. Currently on her way to the ring, from Mobius, this is Annabelle Stillweather!
Seems like she's ready to go for this one.
As far as I know, both Stillweather siblings are going to be in action tonight. Tara we'll see later on. I heard that, pray tell, that there's a Falls Count Anywhere match that Tara requested, and apparently somebody's taken up the challenge, and we'll see it later tonight.
Well, nothing like a good Falls Count Anywhere match to make you feel alive.
Gotta tell you though, Annabelle's got a hell of a challenge here, taking on the Storm.
Well,
then again, Annabelle is a battle-hardened warrior too. I can't see her not making it difficult. If anything,
certainly.
She might have
to be ready for this.
Haven't heard anything yet, to my knowledge, JC.
Here comes one of the strongest women in XBWL history.
Ladies and gentlemen, her opponent representing the Nightmare Imperium and from Avalon. This is Deidre the Storm!
She just stabbed the ring.
First Warden of Thimblewinter on her way down here. This is going to be a hell of a match.
I can imagine that Annabelle is probably going to be in the fight of her life.
Good possibility. I'm going to be completely honest with you, though. If anybody can take on a warrior like Deidre, Annabelle will certainly give it her best shot, and I'm not going to take anything away from her because she's done some pretty damn good things in the ring. Deidre is a challenge for any... I'm just going to say it right now. Any woman on the woman's roster that really wants to test her mettle should get in the ring with Deidre. Deidre is the challenge.
Show this up.
Even if the women's championship is considered prestigious here, you want a real challenge? Survive a match with Deidre.
Sounds like Rocky got a new follower on Twitch.
Annabelle, look at this. Hurricane Rana.
Bruce5576, thank you for becoming corrupted by the Dark Omen.
Tried to go for something, but Deidre counters with a clothesline.
Yeah, holy cow, that size difference is right. Stormy pointing out the size difference, but right now Annabelle with the quicker feet here. Codebreaker.
I'm pretty sure there's a few women on my roster who'd want to challenge Deidre.
Well, I'm talking in general. Bruce, I'm not just talking our roster. I'm talking anybody. You really want to test your mettle, get in the ring with Deidre and see if you can survive.
And now going for a bear hug.
And Deidre is mauling Annabelle with that bear hug and elbow to the side of the head. What were you saying there, Bruce?
I'd rather not get in the ring with Deidre the Storm, considering I actually challenged Violance to a match just to see how long I could last against him. 5 minutes, but still.
One. Jesus.
Annabelle is surprised.
She really shouldn't be.
It's going to take a lot more than that to take out a woman 3 times your size.
Hard forearm. And Deidre, another counter. Grabs a hold of Annabelle, Irish whip off the ropes, and oh my god! Belly to belly suplex! Made sure to lift her right up off the canvas.
If she was close to the ropes, I don't want to know.
Annabelle trying to force Deidre to the ropes. Deidre wouldn't go, so she had to go low for it. And another codebreaker!
Around
the world!
Hurricane Rana.
Annabelle's doing pretty good here. Doing a good job keeping Deidre at bay. Here we go again.
Going for another overhead belly to belly suplex.
I noticed a look on Annabelle's face, just that look on her face when Deidre lifted her right up off her feet, like, really? Deidre going into mauling mode here, picks up Annabelle and chucks her across the ring.
It just tosses her.
Two very, very powerful choke tosses. And Deidre's going out after Annabelle on the floor.
It just made it look like Deidre was about to attack the ref by accident.
If she'd have taken out the ref, she would have forfeited her right to the match.
Hurricane Rana.
Annabelle catching her by surprise with a Hurricane Rana.
Cartwheel leg drop.
And an elbow for good measure. Elbow. Uh-oh. Annabelle caught again. Dragon screw by Jidra.
Picks her up. What are you going to do here?
Oh. Oh, tosses her.
Hair beal. And lifts her up off the canvas. Running.
Deadlift
power
running.
Slam.
Slam.
One. Two. Annabelle kicked out. I don't think Jidra was expecting her to kick out with that much buoyancy, though. Like, she really got herself back up. Oh, double leg pickup.
This is the first time she's stepping in the ring with Annabelle, right?
As far as I know, round the world again. Gonna try a pin. One. Two. And Jidra kicks out with a lot of strength left in the tank. Having a bit of a moment trying to get to her feet here, and Jidra gonna capitalize. Saito suplex.
Oh, what an exploder.
Annabelle almost. Oh my god. Oh!
Oh, German.
Release German.
Annabelle coming within like literally a hair's length of the turnbuckle. Then Jidra grabbing her from behind, lifting her up, and chucking her over with the German. And oh, sleeper hold!
Trying to wear her down.
She's got some good torque on her. Jidra is forcing herself down. This can't be helping with the leverage. I mean, look at the way she's bending back.
It doesn't matter how big you are. Ooh. You cut the blood circulation to your brain, you go night-night.
Yeah, but if she's got her in that standing position, it's also a lot more painful too. Bruce, you ought to know that. If a shorter person's putting the sleeper on a taller person and they're not going down, think of the pressure that's going to be putting on your lower back. Jidra going out of the ring for some reason. Oh, that's why. She's thinking about flying.
Trying to figure out what to do.
Annabelle
Sword
up.
Coming.
Oh my god.
Wheelbarrow DDT.
Out of desperation, but sometimes you'd be surprised what works.
Two.
And again, Jidra kicks
barely
out.
Kick. Just barely at that.
For an elbow.
Annabelle focusing that elbow as much as possible. Jidra rolls out to the floor just to get a breather. And Annabelle thinking about... Oh, God!
Going flat. Just went to air still weather.
A literally rope step senton over the top rope.
I would have called that the head over heels, but what can you do?
And what the hell? Oh, wicked stepsister! Didn't hold it.
Slamming her face right onto the mat. Right onto that floor.
Hey, get in the ring. You don't want to break Mark's table.
Bruce, I will literally send you into the crowd with a bunch of angry fans. And they will maul you.
Hey, I want to see it too.
Dazzle, no! All y'all, forget it. No, let's not do it.
Wait, you think this is the first time I've been in front of a crowd that wanted to kill me?
Up to four now, Jidra just completely... Oh, trying to dominate Annabelle here. Oh, God, oh!
Just pounding away on Annabelle.
If these two aren't careful, this is going to turn out to be a count out, and neither one of them are going to want that.
No, that much is certain.
Up to seven. Ladies, you got to get in the room. Oh, my God. Ooh.
Jeez.
We're up to eight. And both ladies know what's coming. They're getting back in the ring. And Annabelle catching Jidra from behind again. Sleeper hold. Oh.
Didn't hold on to it as long that time.
In and out of it pretty quickly, and Jidra, I think she's starting to get a little bit irritated there.
Annabelle again, round the world. This is what she's got to do, keep the speed going. Gonna try another one, Dragon Sleeper.
Trying to make her submit.
Annabelle got it. Annabelle, that was a surprise. Annabelle locked in her dragon sleeper, and it actually worked.
That had to be brutal for her.
I think it's more so considering the positioning. The problem is you can't really see anything because the ref is directly in the camera thing. So we can't even see how bad the torque was. Nevertheless, Annabelle making it into the XBWL Women's Title Tournament with this win.
And it's good to see that the refs are brain dead here as well as other promotions.
I don't think they were brain dead. I think it was just a really bad spot because of where they were, right in front of the camera. We saw nothing, but apparently there was a tap out.
And now you got one slot left,
which we'll be answering with later tonight, hopefully.
Okay, what's next?
Looking into it. Save that for later. Besides, I already got something in mind. Wait a minute. What did I set this with? Yeah, no. Can't do that. Something's wrong here. My feed is not working. And I can't see what the hell's next on the card. What the fuck is going on here?
We're getting there. I'm trying to figure this out as well.
I don't know. It's just going all static.
That is never a good sign.
Not particularly, no.
Think you're going to have to start taking notes, but then again, I should be fucking taking notes, and I never do that.
Well, I should have been doing that from the start of the show, too, but, you know, what are you going to do? Either way, we'll find out soon enough what the hell's going on. I'm sure it's just technical difficulties. All I'm hearing is MJ screaming in the backstage area to get the prompter working.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, she can't get them to run it any faster than we can.
Let's figure this out. Come on, we have a match to show.
Let's go. Come on. Okay, so what the hell are we doing now? Oh, no.
Oh, great.
We get to have our presence graced by a Burger King of sorts.
and me here without my brass knuckles.
What the hell? Yeah. This is different. Wow, Anderson looks terrible. Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall. Currently on his way to the ring, being accompanied by the Nether Void Queen Scalon. From San Francisco, California, he has labeled himself as the most beautiful king of the Nether Void. This is King Illustrious Eric Anderson!
Sorry, king. I'm allergic to bullshit.
King? Illustrious King? Or King Illustrious Eric Anderson?
Okay, I take back what I said earlier. That wanker looks like a cheap King Arthur ripoff.
He's wearing a lot more green than blue.
Have you guys not been watching the product? He's been wearing this for months.
I've been watching it.
I watch, but anything after 1 a.m. for me is a blur.
I told you to lay off the beer.
And I told
but that's
you
just
to
it.
Quit
we don't
telling
know.
Me that.
We don't know what's going on here, because here's the thing. Scalon and Anderson are here, but we didn't even see who his damn opponent was.
Maybe it's a mystery.
What the hell? Jim, you want to explain this?
Oh, dear God, he's here. He's actually here.
Ladies and gentlemen, Eric's opponent from San Francisco, California, and being accompanied by Daddy G. This is the one last gangstar, Adam Anderson!
The former XPWO world champion.
Figured he'd come back. Come full circle, here we go. Eric's brother.
Maybe he might beat the sense back into his brother, but then again, I doubt that would ever happen.
He never did beat any sense into his brother. They hate each other. On top of that, I'm going to welcome back Adam Anderson because, yeah, you're right, Jim. He's pretty much done it all. XBWL World Champion, him and Anderson both share one XBWL World title win apiece. But, going to be completely honest with you, Adam held the title a lot longer than Eric ever did.
Well, that much is obvious.
These two, similar build, but two completely different backgrounds.
Hip toss.
And Eric is screaming at him, why are you back? You shouldn't have never come back.
You think he cares?
Not at all. Gut-wrench!
Adam Anderson making a name for himself in the YWL after he decided to leave XPWL for a short time.
Like I said, he left the company for a while. Looks like he completely rebuilt himself and came back. He's a grizzled veteran compared to what he was when he left. Anderson has stayed here. He hasn't really traveled much outside of XPWL stuff, and the only stuff that he did do, well, he didn't have much of a run. So
he was former. Both these two share a Flight of Domination title reign.
They also share a lot of things, flesh and blood being one of them. Oh, God. Tilt-a-whirl slam.
If anyone here knows about hating their brother, it's you, Jim, isn't it?
Oh, don't remind me.
Eric just laying into him.
Second elbow.
Oh, stepping on his face. Come on, man. That's your brother, for God's sake.
You think he gives a shit?
Obviously not, and I would think he would care even less with Scalon out there at ringside with him.
Is it just me, or did he try to break his own brother's nose, considering his nose gets broken every other match?
He could be, I don't know. But I don't think Anderson cares. Anderson's actually dealt with injuries before, unlike Eric.
Well, yeah, he... both Adam is a
Whoa.
Street rat.
I think it might have been JC, to be completely honest with you.
It could have been.
Oh my God!
Well, he's getting out of it.
I'll give both Adam and Eric this. They both have incredible physiques. I think the only difference is Adam doesn't flaunt his around like he's God's gift to men and women. Anderson on the other hand, and oh, look at this! Daddy G playing a little bit of Scalon and Eric's own mind games here. Distracting Eric. Adam ducks under in a back elbow.
Duck down.
No, Daddy G has gotten a lot bigger since the last time I've seen him.
Yeah, he's bulked up. Look at that. For all we know, Daddy G might actually... Really? We haven't seen him in a while. The last time we saw him was Steam Division. That was back in 2020.
Well, YWL. Well, Dank Drake and him actually are former YWL tag champs.
Wait, where'd that chair come from?
I think Daddy.
Oh, jeez.
I think Daddy G pulled it out from under the ring to distract the referee. But we're not getting anywhere here. We're at five. And Anderson trying another power bomb, and Adam will not let it happen. We're up to seven. Eric getting back in the ring, and look at Adam here. He actually shot Scalana. Look, I thought he was going to go after her for a second.
I saw it too, honestly. Stun gun. And Adam pushes Eric away.
Adam sends Eric into the ropes. Whip. Ducks under. Oh, flying hip toss.
Oh, jeez.
One. Only one after all that? And Eric put in position, up and power bomb.
Adam sending, ooh.
Eric's down onto the mat.
But drop. Considering how that was done, looks like he was trying to stop his own brother's heart.
Yeah, you never know. You'd also got to take in mind, now that he's aligned with Skalon, if Eric even has one. And whoa. Oh my god! Up into the press slam! Power slam!
Did the fucking bastard even have a heart to begin with?
Probably not.
Well, he wasn't. Being in love with himself. Oh! Hard punch!
Punch to the face!
Oh my god! Spear!
And, annihilating Adam there!
One, two!
One, two!
Anderson kicks out! And Eric's throwing a fit!
He wants to cripple him.
Whoa, I think he went for the forearm.
I think to go for the punch to the face.
Either a punch to the face or that forearm shot of his.
Oh, snake eyes.
Well, he rolled the dice.
And alley-oop powerbomb.
Dragged out of the corner the hard way.
Adam's going to find himself in trouble here if he doesn't get something going. There we go. Trying to get him back to his feet. There's a shot to the nose. And Adam lying in wait for his brother.
Go for it here.
What the hell is he doing? Oh, picks him up.
Oh.
What the hell?
Oh, look at this.
Whoa.
The FU.
What a modified FU on that. I've never seen anybody do it from that position before.
Neither have I. And I've been seeing him wrestle.
Arm drag. And Eric going up top. What the hell is he doing? Oh!
Oh, matches it!
That was a picture-perfect elbow drop. He flew across the ring and still managed to hit it. And, this could be a problem. Trying to get around Skalon, who is deliberately blocking his way.
I think I just heard him say, "Get out of my way, bitch."
I think I've heard something like that, too.
Yeah, now I'm hearing Skalon barking orders to take him out. Oh, my God. No, not that landing.
The back of Adam Anderson's head just hit the steel steps.
Well, he's going to be seeing stars after this.
Skalon is literally screaming, "Deal with this problem and let's go." Up to seven.
Stay here.
No, I don't think she wants to deal with Anderson.
Adam.
Adam, yeah. And Eric, breaking the count, that was stupid. He had the count out victory and even Skalon screaming at him, "What are you doing?"
I think he just wants to finish him the old fashioned way.
Adam took a dive, it didn't work. Oh, shot to the head. And Eric grabbing a hold of him. Oh, clothesline. Eric might have Adam's number here if he's not careful. Oh, stomping on the face.
And Eric going under the top rope.
This is kind of unceremonious. An elbow drop of his own and a kick to the face.
What a boot.
Almost took his head off. One. Only one. Holy shit. These two are going to kill each other out here. Oh, there it is. Oh, no.
Punch the back.
Neck breaker. What a counter. Saw the forearm coming and caught his hand. Uh-oh. Here we go. Uh-oh. FU coming up again. No.
Him up on his... No.
Double finisher counter. Anderson. Oh, tried again and it didn't work. Adam! Oh, he got caught!
Uh-oh, up on his shoulders!
Stop! Power slam! Eric, one, two, three. Eric picks up the win over his brother.
These two have traded wins back and forth before.
Oh, I know, but still, look at the look on Anderson's face while he's getting out of the ring. He did not want to fight Adam tonight. And the look on his face says, I shouldn't have expended that much energy. Adam.
Both of them two are going to be feeling that tomorrow.
Guaranteed. Still, Anderson, like, Eric is looking over at Scalon and telling her, like, looking at her like, oh my god, like, this was too close. Here is your winner, Eric Anderson! Scalon.
All right, now that
that was a hell of
that
a
match
pose
is over,
that didn't need
back
to be
off the both of you.
Scalon and Anderson just yelled out to Adam and Danny G, welcome back to the big leagues, bitch. That's not going to set well with either of them.
No, it isn't. What a fight, though.
It was. I wasn't expecting Adam here. I also wasn't expecting them to tear the house down.
Eesh.
Honestly, JC, I'm starting to wonder if maybe Scalon's influence is having an effect on his mind.
Maybe just a little bit.
Let's see. Oh, this could get interesting. I know this match was requested. Remember what I said about Tara Stillweather looking for a match tonight and looking for any challenger? Well, she definitely found one. Tara Stillweather steps into the ring with Magic Mare in a Falls Count Anywhere contest.
I don't know what to expect with this. I just know that it's...
Gone.
I just know that this is going to be pretty brutal.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall and will be contested under Falls Count Anywhere rules. Currently on her way to the ring, from Mobius and representing the New Warp, she is the leader of the New Warp and also one half of the XBWL Women's Tag Team Champions, Tara Stillweather!
Oh. This is going to be interesting. Both these women have solid reputations.
Tara also a very proud champion alongside Ward and Gale. I mean, you got to think how long the Warp has been here and how many times they've captured tag team gold. On top of that, Tara has plenty of other accolades, not just that.
Former women's shooting star and hardcore champion.
We still got it. That's right. Stormy's exactly right. Tara is a Grand Slammer. The funny thing is so is this one.
Eesh.
Well, she is a Triple Crown champion in ACW, but we haven't had a Grand Slammer yet since we introduced the Emerald Championship.
Weird name for a title.
And not really. I mean, I once wrestled in a promotion and that main championship was called the Grand Emerald title or the Emerald Crown.
Kara's opponent from Equestria and representing the subjects. This is the great and magnificent Magic Mare!
Did his mic just cut off?
Might have.
Oh, it did from my end, but I'm pretty sure the stream just heard it.
Could have been either way.
But nevertheless, one of the top names in the XPWO Women's Division, a former multi-time XPWO Women's Champion, coming here tonight, seeing if she can get back what was taken from her.
Hey, don't forget, she's also held titles in other promotions.
Well, that I'm aware.
I also remember Magic Mare saying that right now she is not it. This is kind of weird coming from Magic Mare, but she said this year she doesn't want to focus on championships.
Are you kidding?
Magic Mare said she wants to focus on her notoriety and fame. She wants to win over the fans. She's already got fanfare. That's something that she's not without an abundance of, obviously. Look at Rockadile, for example. But she wants to win over the fans, and she feels that winning a championship isn't going to do that. She's already won them all. She's already been a Grand Slammer herself. Right now, she wants to focus on being that lowering platform that Magic Mare was on, JC. That's what I was talking about.
Yeah, if you're not in a wrestling promotion to try to become champion, why the hell are you there in the first place?
It's not the factor that she's not wanting to be a champion. She doesn't want to be a champion right now. And what the hell? That was a glitch.
I didn't see anything. I blinked. I missed it. Leapfrog. Duck down.
And no, Hurricanrana.
Nice Hurricanrana to start things off. Tara starting with some fast action here, grabbing Magic Mare by the hair and pulling her down with a reverse DDT. Nice counter. Magic Mare grabbing a hold of her and look, whoa.
What the strength?
Well, to be fair, Magic Mare does look like she's got a bit of muscle on her this year. Another Hurricanrana. Ooh. Tara using the Hurricanrana to a great effect in this match. Leg scissors.
Tag team partner is in the ACW solitary confinement match. That's going to be an interesting match to watch.
Front slam.
Oh, double leg drop and making Tara sit face to face to her. And oh! Tara answers back with a vicious bicycle kick. Leapfrog.
It's over.
Ducks under, comes back across. Oh, and a knee lift.
The brutality with those bicycle kicks. And oh, springboard stunner.
Magic Mare's in deep trouble here. Only a one count. Magic Mare's got to get some offense going here. Tara, it's been pretty much all Tara since the opening bell. Try to chop. That didn't work. Tara again grabbing Magic Mare, taking her to the ropes this time, and Magic Mare dumps her over the top. Goes out after her. Remember, false count anywhere. It doesn't matter what they do out here. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Oh!
Right into the barricade.
Those may look like gold bars, but that's just gold-plated, guys. Those are metal, and they hurt a lot.
Yeah, they do.
No.
Whoa, nice spear acrobat. Spear.
And a second spear.
Nice acrobatics on that one, and Magic Mare is going for toys. And, holy shit, if Magic Mare hadn't have gotten in the ring right there, she would have gotten nailed by that. Good God. Talk about the skin of your teeth.
I think that pissed off Tara a little.
Oh, bicycle kick.
One of her own.
Both Magic Mare and Tara utilizing the bicycle kick in their arsenal. just different styles. Magic Mare trying to go for a grapple. Tara says, hell no, and there's a stunner.
Oh, fuck.
Wakey, wakey, ref. One, two.
Only a two.
Ref kind of caught napping on that one. I'm not even going to try to contest that. And, oh, God, broke the kendo stick over Magic Mare.
Yeah, Tara is now pissed.
Yo, those fucking kendo sticks don't tickle.
Obviously. I think I've been to the brunt force of one of those.
I like using them, but I sure as hell hate taking them. And Magic Mare trying to get some offense going here, and what the hell? Uh-oh.
Grand
what the hell? No! Cat's Claw!
What the?
She's imitating the Cat's Claw on Tara! And Tara, oh my God, the look on her face.
She is there.
Whoa, roll up! One,
most lethal move
two.
In wrestling.
And oh God, Cat's Claw! And that might
this
be
time
it.
This time on to Magic Mare.
Magic Mare might not be able to fight it off.
Doesn't look like it.
Tara.
She's struggling.
She's still in the game. I'm impressed. Magic Mare managing to keep herself alive here. And it, whoa. Nice kick.
One, two.
Only a two.
Magic Mare getting
Magic
frustrated.
Mare can't believe it.
Yeah, she's getting really frustrated now. And oh my God.
Jeez.
That came out of nowhere.
Just a stomp.
Goomba
and
stomp.
Turning Magic Mare inside out.
Goomba stomp of the century.
I don't know why she was dragging her away from the ropes. These kind of matches have no rope break.
It's not the point. She's trying to do it to send a message. And Magic Mare again fighting it off. Honestly, I'm going to say she got lucky on that one. Because Tara, yeah, she's far from done. And Midnight Drive.
Oh, swinging neckbreaker. And sending her to the outside of the ring.
If Magic Mare doesn't get anything going for her, she's pretty much done. Tara is mauling her. Oh,
Magic
God.
Magic Mare
has
a little bit in trouble.
No! Oh! That Goomba stomp really threw Magic Mare off her game. She did get a counter, but she just can't capitalize on it. Tara's hitting her with everything, even the kitchen sink. Magic Mare
so
trying to go for
it. Can wrestle with heels.
Front plex. Oh, super kick.
Hard one at that.
And she's going for another toy. What's she going to grab?
Chair. Oh!
No, cracking her skull open right in the bottom corner.
And her knee at the same time.
Went for the legs there. That didn't work. Magic Mare again. No, she's not done with the chair yet.
Jeez.
Well, Tara broke that kendo stick over her body earlier. And oh no. Oh no. Oh!
Oh no! Oh jeez!
That was close. If she'd have got
did land.
You think so? I didn't see if Magic Mare's neck hit the chair, but it was dangerously close.
It had to have hit.
Yeah, Magic Mare's favoring her neck. That just might be what happened. And Tara exploiting it to her advantage. Magic Mare back on her feet.
Drop kick.
Oh, kick to the stomach, and she might be thinking about it. Picks her up. Grand spectacle. One, two. Tara kicks out.
Two.
The fuck is she made of?
Whatever.
What the hell? Oh my God! Grand finale!
The double moonsault.
One, two, three.
That's it.
Magic,
and the move gets her to finish.
Magic Mare never busts out the grand finale unless she feels that she can't win any other way. The fact that she had to do that right after a grand spectacle just showed that Magic Mare, as much as she won the match, she got by the skin of her teeth. It took her desperation to score the victory.
And now she'll get to celebrate backstage with Ragadoll.
Certainly.
Here is your winner, Magic Mare! What a match, though. Magic Mare with the grand finale. Like I said, it is so rare that we see her bring that out, but when she does, very rare that she doesn't claim victory after nailing it.
Jeez.
You gotta wonder how hurt she is after that match, though. The cat's claw is nothing to be scoffed at, either. To have something fun here.
It's a nice. Yeah.
I would figure as much. Tara's a warrior. If she's going to go out, she's going to go out swinging. So, you know, like I said, big win for her. Not gonna take that away from her, that's for sure.
Certainly.
Let's see. Apparently we're getting a new face tonight and another familiar one.
Who?
Well, you'll see.
Oh, one of them. Why do I have a bad feeling about this?
You should always have bad feelings about this.
I would think having bad feelings about this would be normal. Ladies and gentlemen, the next match is going to be an elimination table match. And do not adjust your sets. By the looks of it, we've got ourselves Texan Gamer, Pedro Munoz of the LWO. This new guy, I don't have any information other than his name is Rolando. And the guy on the right, I'm not sure what his allegiance is, because it's been a long time since anyone has seen him, Malenko. The Sawtooth Viper.
So I'm getting in the ring with Nathan Hart some time ago.
Oh, here we go. This is your boy, Jim. He's all yours.
Oh, boy. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the participants first. If you have no idea where he comes from, then for the love of God, just get a map already or something, you unintelligent piece of crap. This is the Certified Scout Main, Texan!
Well, seems we all have a different intro for this guy.
It all depends on who you're going, who he's announcing, or what we feel like saying. Doesn't matter if it's a map, it's globe, or if you need to get them an education.
I'll get the Encyclopedia Britannica.
Or that too, yeah.
Oh boy.
It's been a minute since you've seen him.
Ladies and
this guy's about gone.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next participant in this match, he is from Juarez, Chihuahua, Mexico. He is the Mechanic of Suplex City and a member of the Latino World Order, LWO. This is Pedro Munoz.
Oh boy.
You know he's gone.
The Mechanic has returned.
You know if he's about, his tag team partner's about, and if they're about, check your pockets every 5 seconds.
Well, if Pedro's out here, who knows how many bags Bandito's gone through in the back.
I swear to God, if he's stealing my beer.
Actually, El Bandito didn't steal your beer. I did.
Oh, for God's sake, Bruce, I wasn't done drinking that!
And I don't know why you're drinking that weakest piss beer anyway. You want a real beer? Get a West End.
It's either that or get Canadian beer. I have a bunch of them down underneath the table if you want to grab one.
Oh boy.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next participant making his debut in the XPWL. He is from San Juan, Puerto Rico. This is Ronaldo.
This guy. No. Yeah!
The 1970s cold. They want their hairstyle back.
I don't think that's their choice.
I don't know, man. Give the guy credit. A Hawaiian shirt and gold chains. He comes from Puerto Rico. I know that he has a beachfront home. The guy's actually a pretty good... The guy's been a pretty good free agent in the Caribbean Indies. Trying to make a name for himself. I think we brought him in here from, I think we brought him in here as part of a new talent initiative.
Might have to invite him for a match to ACW so we can have a fight with Tonga Tua.
Oh boy, here we go.
Oh jeez.
You want to announce him, Jim, since he's already been on your show?
You go.
Ladies and gentlemen, the final participant in this match, from wherever he wants, apparently, according to this page, he is the Sawtooth Viper, Malenko! JC, the reason why he's got that bag is because he's got a live Viper in it.
If he wins this match, don't tell me to run, because you'll be speaking to yourself. Fucking hate snakes.
Well, I do too, but you don't see me running away like a baby, do you?
Yes, Jim? JC, he has his own personal viper that he keeps with him.
Jim, if you've seen the kind of snakes we have in my country, you'd run away too.
Oh, I've ran away from rattlesnakes when I was a kid.
Also, take in mind, I think he's probably going to keep his viper out of this one, considering this is a tables match. And it's elimination rules.
Oh, spine buster.
He's kind of a double imitation, actually. Oh my god! Well, Ronaldo's gone! That was quick! Thanks for coming out, rookie! That has gotta be a fucking record for eliminations! He wasn't even in the match. He wasn't even in the match for 25 seconds.
Someone clip that and put a timer
yes, please,
on.
Somebody, yes, help. Please, somebody clip that. I will add a timer to it if I can.
What the fuck, bro?
JC, give the guy a chance. This is literally his first night in XPWL. Texan just gave him the usual hazing welcome from the locker room.
Well,
and,
that's straight more clothesline on the Malenko.
That was the funniest thing I've ever seen.
That was epic. I never thought we'd get an elimination that quick, and here Texan is just, yeah, sorry, Fro boy. Nope.
Well, he has always good speed, so.
You know, look at this.
Texan getting cocky and paid for it.
Never mind.
Pedro takes out Malenko, and now Pedro over the top rope.
Out of the ring he goes. Hey, whoa!
Yes, JC, he's part of the new talent initiative. It's his literal first night on the job. Give the guy a chance.
Probably. Not everybody can win their first match. I mean, hell's bells. I mean, I didn't win a match for my first five.
We know you want tables, crowd. You already got a break. You already got a break within the first 25 seconds of the match.
I think they just want more. I'm not saying that line. I've got dignity. Not much, but I've got some.
Oh wow! Drop kick into the right into the concrete here. Pedro and Texan working each other over. Pedro, and Malenko and Texan are going right after each other here.
And right next to us, for crying out loud. Get away, guys!
Hey, lucky I'm on the other side of the table.
Whoa!
I'm in front of the action here.
Guys, you need to get... Oh, Pedro, ready to the side of my table here. Guys, you need to get out of here. And Malenko... Ooh.
Mike.
Oh, landing on our table here.
Guys,
hey,
no!
I might joke about your table getting broken, but I don't really want to see it.
I don't think my table actually counts. No. And even so, they are not putting themselves through my goddamn table.
Actually, going through the announce tables do count.
Yeah, so you're skipping.
Oh!
Right on the edge.
Everybody's all over each other here, mauling, and oh, Pedro right into the post.
Well, you'll be happy now. They're away from your table.
Just barely.
Texan trying to get Malenko back into the ring.
I thought Texan was going for a low blow for a second.
Wait, does Texan even do that kind of thing? Because I've never seen him do it.
I don't think he would. Malenko stalking Texan there and caught him, but didn't catch him with that clothesline.
Oh, trying to go for a super kick, but Pedro stops him.
What the hell?
Hey, where you going? There's no table there.
Oh!
There's the super kick.
Malenko caught by surprise.
Well, JC, there is an old saying, keep your words soft and sweet because you might have to eat them later.
No. Here. Oh, punch to the face.
Pedro gone for a ladder.
This ain't a TLC match. Uh-oh.
Oh, my God. Oh!
I thought he was about to land on the ladder there.
Uh-oh.
That would have been a painful flashback for the three of us, wouldn't it?
Malenko almost got himself put through the table. And Pedro trying to bring Texan over to it. Texan says, hell no.
Well, he had some other idea. Back elbow strike.
Trying to fight his way out here. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
Oh! And Texan's eliminated. Double even flow and landing on the ladder head first.
Then flipping onto the table. Man, that's a bad combination right there.
Oh, you think he might have a head injury?
He might? Might? I can guarantee you he's got a concussion after that. Malenko picks up Pedro. Pedro counters.
Uh-oh. Oh, DDT.
Right into that
close
table
ladder,
chunk.
But still. Whoa. Is his arm just sticking up in midair like that? What the hell is going on?
Because his arm is up against the ladder. It's bending the wrong direction. Malenko set out to the apron. Pedro's got him on the ropes here. One good move and oh, down he goes.
Oh, jeez.
Right into that pile. Right into that broken table that we saw at the beginning of the match.
Where the fuck did that chair come from?
That's a good question.
I think it was probably one of the chairs from near us.
Ooh, bulldog.
And the Russian leg sweep.
Oh, God.
You know, telling Texan to lie down still is a waste of time.
Backstabber from Pedro. And, German suplex. Pedro thinking about grabbing something.
Another table.
He is a multi-time tag team champion in several different promotions, so he must know what he's doing.
Oh, of course Pedro knows what he's doing, but still, a little surprised. I would have figured he would have set that table up outside the ring, but no. And now, trying to confuse Malenko. Into the corner. Missed. And a clothesline. And oh my God!
Top rope!
He watched Pedro slide out of the ring and jumped simultaneously, landing right on top of him.
He didn't even do a running jump. He just did a standing jump. That's impressive.
That's a hell of a leap to make, especially with it being a free fall. He didn't even use the ropes for leverage. That's a hell of a jump.
Oh, for being a viper to a jaguar. Jaguar.
Oh, right
car
or
a cat?
Oh!
Cat. What, do cars jump, Bruce?
Yes. If they run off, if they drive fast into a ramp, yes, they do jump.
That don't count.
And lowriders jump.
They're not very high.
Oh, boy. Now we've got a... Oh, now we've got a chair. We've got a... An obsession
ladder.
With using the steel steps.
We have a ladder, we have tables, we have ladders, we have chairs.
And this isn't even a Carpenter's Wet Dream match. Butterfly suplex.
Sorry, Jim set that up, I had to knock it down.
You're gonna get joke flown at you later.
You say that like it's a bad thing.
It is for you.
Malenko, it's just continuously mauling Pedro here, and he's... This is a thing that scares me about Malenko. He gets this perverse joy in causing pain.
And he doesn't even share a smile.
Hell no. Ugh. But you can tell when he's out there in the element, when he's hurting somebody, you can literally feel that joy that he gets from freaking watching people suffer. Remember, he's all... Remember...
A drop kick.
Malenko is also quite loyal to a certain queen we all despise.
Really? I thought she hated her. I thought he hated her.
I thought so too, but it's a ruse. Oh no. What the hell? Oh! Butterfly backbreaker!
Bloody hell, my monitor went out again. Hang on a second. There we go, back up.
I think Pedro's getting tired here.
Pedro's definitely getting tired, and Malenko just keeps coming at him. And guys, not my table!
I'm worried they're not gonna go taking your stuff off.
Well, it's kind of complicated, JC. He claims he's loyal, but he's not loyal. I don't know. Malenko is very hard to figure out.
Oh yeah, that much is obvious.
We know that he is incredibly jealous of any minions that Scalon has. In fact, I think he had a jealousy fit over Abaddon of all people.
Wait, what the hell is Pedro getting now? Another ladder?
Oh no.
I was joking. I was fucking joking.
Oh, your little... joke turned into reality.
Oh, what a chop. I would say he's a wild card, but nobody knows whose side he's on. Honestly, I think he's just on the side of himself. He works with whoever's causing the most misery. Oh!
No!
Pedro could have broke his ass doing that.
He probably did.
Waiting for his chance off the top! Arm drag off the top to the floor!
Come on. Any stuff or a simple move like that? Come on, really?
The fact that he pulled it off from that height?
The hell is up with him trying to stomp on his head? Oh! Wrestle takedown.
They gotta get back in the ring where all those.
Match like this.
They gotta get back in the ring, goddammit. Pedro, what the hell is. Oh! Oh!
Whoa, what the
Oh my god, Malenko, the corner in the corner of that chair leg caught him right in the face. There's the timekeeper's bell. And oh, Pedro right into the post. Pedro's already a bloody mess. And oh, front plex. And, you gotta wonder how
they can finish this, you two.
Yeah, Malenko is really prolonging the suffering here.
Maybe that's the point.
Oh, I'm sure of it.
Going. Oh.
Taking his sweet time. Nope. Pedro again with another counter.
The knee.
Trying, and Pedro might actually manage to get rid of Malenko here, and he does it!
Howdy, ew. That's a surprise.
Pedro was suffering, and he somehow managed to get himself out. Right here, look at this. Poor Ronaldo right over the top through the table. And here's Texas elimination. Like I said, he's got to have a concussion after that.
That could not have felt good.
Here is your winner, Pedro Munoz!
And celebrate it out here tonight.
Wonder which one of them made the bet that whoever wins buys the beer.
Or whoever wins steals the beer.
I don't steal everything, Bruce.
Have you met El Bandito?
Plenty of times.
And have you checked your pocket every time?
Usually.
I mean, I once had a mouse trap in my pocket just to see what he'd do, and the bastard bloody, he didn't set it off. He still stole my wallet anyway.
But clearly he has magic.
Or pickpocketing skills. But though he wouldn't dare try to steal anyone's wallet in front of Sledgehammer, because you know what Sledgehammer's like.
Yeah.
Here we go. Whoever wins this one is guaranteed the last spot in the XBWL Women's Title Tournament. The Shinobi Kitsune locking up with Hanabi Dead Fox.
You two, excuse me, I need to go use the announcer's room. Be right back.
Okay.
All right.
Stormy's right. Double Kitsune fight tonight.
Double?
Yes, they're both Kitsune. Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is a qualifier for the XBWL Women's Championship Tournament. On her way to the ring, representing the Nightmare Imperium, this is the Shinobi Kitsune, Alana!
Boy, she's ready for this one. He wants this opportunity.
JC, part of the reason for that is because we've run out of people that do not have titles currently that we can actually put into the tournament legally. Other ones have either dates with championship matches already, or they have titles themselves.
Or you could consider this a second chance for her.
Maybe so. Besides, it was either give Dead Fox a second chance or give it to Scalon, and I don't think anybody would have wanted to do that.
Hell the fuck no.
Is that a kendo stick?
Ladies and gentlemen, Alana's opponent from the Japanese Spirit Lands. This is the Kitsune Mercenary, Hanabi Dead Fox.
It's a fucking kendo stick she's bringing with her.
Oh. At least she's leaving it outside the ring.
Hey, be happy it's not a sword.
Close enough. You get hit with those things, you're gonna feel it. You might not get stabbed or get cut with it, but you're definitely gonna feel it. Besides, I've felt one of Dead Fox's kendo stick shot. She has hit me across the lower back before. It is like getting cut with a sword, I'll tell you that. She's got a fucking hell of a swing on her. Excuse me.
Well, I've still got welts on my back from kendo shots I took fucking years ago, so I know what those feel like.
And already we're starting off with speed.
I mean, hell, why do you think I wrestle with a t-shirt on now?
Oh, nice neckbreaker.
Oh, jeez.
What a neckbreaker.
Beautiful.
Dropkick.
Hanabi can definitely pack a punch. I know that for a fact. We all know that from experience, but both Alana and Dead Fox, both of them have the experience needed to excel in this business, and Alana is not wasting any time. Dead Fox, both of them are actually going pretty good, tooth and nail with each other here. Oh! Pulling off their favorite tricks here, no doubt. Alana going outside, and here comes Dead Fox into a hurricanrana off the top rope. Beautiful delivery,
Mark,
these
your
two.
Mark, your management really needs to spring for better monitors. Mine's went out on me a few times.
I'm seeing it just fine.
I don't know what the hell it is. Maybe it's your connection. I don't know. Up to four already. Whoa.
Hurricanrana.
Back into the ring, and Dead Fox catching Alana by surprise with a DDT and a kick to the side.
A float over DDT.
Whoa. Either way, these two really displaying not only their agility, but their power.
Get in the ring. I don't want to see a count out.
I don't want to see either of them have a broken leg after this, but they are really laying into each other hard. Whoa. And Alana springboard, but underneath.
Misses.
Oh!
Oh, geez. Implant DDT.
Executioner's DDT. Nope.
Would somebody be vaping here?
I don't even touch that stuff.
Whoa.
Oh, jeez.
Jumping kick. I have no idea what the hell that sound was. I mean, I do have a vape pen, but I'm not using it right now.
Why the f*** is that stuff? It's such a bloody unhealthy habit.
I'm not talking that kind of vaping. On top of that, it doesn't matter anyway. We got a match here, and Dead Fox with a combo there, ending with a nice roundhouse. And whoa, tried to go after her, and again, Alana now. Both ladies turning up the speed, and if I didn't know better, look at Alana's back. She's got bruises. Oh, high angle DDT. And oh! Tilt-a-whirl facebuster. Alana going up to the top now. And
rent district.
450 Close. Elbow. One, two. If the hippie's nearby and that was a vape pen, JC, I'm sorry to say that he might have turned heel. Oh my God, again? Second time, did not connect this time.
Went to the well one time too many.
There's whip. Looks Duck. Underneath.
Drop kick.
And a drop kick.
And oh, spinning corkscrew splash. And went for another one. That one didn't work. Dead Fox off the ropes. Undershot the jump. Alana was too
Actually,
close.
I think the overshot.
Whoa.
Overshot.
Yeah, overshot. Sorry.
It's a mistake. Easy mistake to make.
Oh, backstabber.
Backstabber.
Into a headlock submission. And Alana taps out.
Oh, that was quick. Jesus.
She had no choice. She had to tap, otherwise she would have snapped.
Dead Fox did have her bent back pretty far.
We're getting all... We're going crazy here tonight, aren't we?
Pretty much. Well, all the slots have been filled, but... Again, I think it might have been the way that Alana landed. That was a bad landing from that 450 elbow drop the second time around. Might have cost her.
Let's get the official word.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Dead Fox.
And showing respect to the crowd. You know, I do like that. I mean, I've wrestled in Japan.
More than likely, the way she landed, like I said, she's landing on her side and on her thigh, so I can only imagine how painful that would have been if she missed. What time is it?
Yes.
Alrighty. Ow.
Well, the show's been going for an hour and a half. Do you have any ACW stars scheduled for tonight?
Not that I'm aware of. I know that they more than likely could be in a match if at all. Just give me a moment. I'm looking through here. What the hell am I looking at?
Excuse me?
I mean, seriously, what the hell am I looking at here?
Excuse me?
Guys, are you seeing what I'm seeing here?
Anyway.
Holy shit.
Oh my God.
Alright.
He's been missing for 2 months. Look at him. Oh my God.
Christ, so fucking mighty. Alright, Bruce, you want to make a bet? How much do you want to say that Sledgehammer's going to kill him within 5 minutes?
Oh, why is
That's not really a fair bet.
Oh, why is that garbage logo on our screen?
Don't worry, it doesn't exist.
Alright, the following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from Seattle, Washington. He is the head of the ACW security team, the current holder of the Grab for Glory briefcase and the ring breaker. This is Sledgehammer. I wonder when he's gonna cash that in.
I don't know, but I get the feeling feeling Charlie is not gonna survive.
Honestly, the way he looks right now, I'm very concerned. Like, here's the thing. I get it. He's supposedly a member of the Black Hand, but at the same point, like, we've seen what happened since he failed her that one time, and he's looking worse and worse and worse, and we haven't seen him in almost 2 months, and look at him!
He's still acting the way he's acting.
I don't even think he knows who he is anymore. Look at his face! I mean, yeah, the beard's not there like we used to know, but look at his eye!
Okay, I'm not going to make that comment, but are you showing any it sounds like you're showing concern for this guy.
Well, look at him! Think about it! Like, at least 5 months ago, he had the physique. Him and I almost looked at it. Other than his hair, if we'd have had the same hairstyle and you had us both in the same room, other than maybe his skin being paler than mine, you wouldn't have been able to tell between the two of us. Look at him! Whatever the hell Scalon gave him, if he's going through any kind of withdrawal symptoms from it, all I can say is oh my god. Like, the muscle is gone. Like, look at how scraggly he looks. He looks just like he did when he was living in the dumpster full time, without Scalon's influence. On top of that, he just looks miserable.
Maybe putting him in the ring with Sledgehammer is going to be like a mercy kill for him.
Sledgehammer's going to annihilate him.
Holy shit, look at the size difference between these two.
At least Charlie's trying to fight, I'll give him that. Oh no. Letting the blood rush to his head.
Alright, Sledge, no need to show off like that.
Considering Charlie barely looks like he's 100 pounds out there.
Millie's still trying to fight.
Still got something fighting him. That would be probably the equivalent of a mosquito trying to smack a brontosaurus or something.
Possibly. Sledgehammer is going to destroy him here. Look at this. No effort whatsoever. Charlie's barely fighting back. Is Charlie even going to be able to compete at all in this match? I doubt it. Oh! If he isn't broken to pieces. What the hell did we just see? Did Sledgehammer just try to do a moonsault?
I'm still surprised a guy his size can move like that. Well, he may have attempted it, but he missed. Okay, what the hell was Sledge trying to do there? Spear or something?
We're up to seven. And they're back in the ring. Charlie taking Sledge over to the ropes. And oh wow, knee lift.
One, two. Okay, I think he's a bit confused.
Oh!
Body slam, tossed aside.
Oh no, grabbing him by the hair. And yeah, Charlie is not putting up any offense here. Sledgehammer's just playing with him now. Oh, maybe not. Whatever it is, he better think of something quick here. Oh, spine buster. That might be it.
And
one, two.
Two. Stay down, you mongrel, for your own health. What the hell? What the hell is Sledge doing? Oh, don't go up there.
Oh. Charlie thinking about going for something here. grab him by the arms and stomping the hell out of his back. That's the most offense he's done in this match so far. And again, tried the STO, that didn't work.
Looks like he was gonna go for the ripcord knee.
Charlie, oh my god, he actually did a springboard move. There is no way in hell that's doing damage.
No way. Nice belly to belly. Wait.
Oh my god.
Double underhook powerbomb.
Sledgehammer is gonna just... Oh my god! Dropping Charlie on the concrete chest first. Charlie, if you're smart, don't bother getting out of the ring. Or don't bother getting back in the ring. And Sledgehammer, elbow drop.
Pounds landing on his chest. At least I'm assuming that's what Sledgehammer weighs.
Belly to belly suplex.
Did he just do a helo over the top rope?
Yes. Charlie trying to fight back.
No wonder this guy was hired as security for ACW.
He's got cat-like reflexes, I'll give him that. Charlie refusing to get back into the ring, and Sledgehammer saying, no, you're going back in, whether you like it or not. Boom! Oh, spear out of nowhere! And trying for a pin? One, two.
There was no way he would have got it with that.
Charlie getting in some good shots here. And jumped over the top.
And back into the ring. Jim, you there? You've been quiet all match.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Gotta be it.
That might be it. One, two. Yeah, Charlie's out. He's not even moving.
He is knocked out cold.
Can we get some EMTs down here to maybe get Charlie out of the ring? At least before the witch and the king try to take him? Because I guarantee you they're probably lurking around backstage waiting for the chance to grab him.
Well, medic team, go out there quick. Well, let's get the official word. Here is your winner, Sledgehammer. Wait, where'd that nightstick come from? I know that's his trademark weapon, but where the hell did it come from? He didn't go to the ring with it.
I have no idea.
I mean, I know it's charmed with some kind of elemental energy, but I didn't think that could just teleport out of nowhere.
Maybe, maybe not.
I guess you could say that was an easy night for Sledgehammer.
Definitely was. I think tonight in particular, considering it's already 9:30, we've got time for one more match.
So the main event of the evening.
At least for now.
Is it going to be a men or women's?
More than likely going to be a men's match.
Alright.
Partially a request. Just give me a second here, I gotta find the right people for it.
Fresh.
whatever the hell's going on, our prompter's not working again. So that's not helping matters either.
Man, your production truck needs the bloody upgrade.
It's either that or the Gretchens need to start remembering what the hell is even going on here.
Why the fuck do you hire those creepy little things?
Cheap labor and easy to get them to operate stuff. That's why they were hired in the first place. Problem is that when things go wrong, they tend to panic before they actually do anything.
Yeah, cheap labor, you get what you pay for.
Yeah, maybe, but they're still usually really good, so let's see what we're getting here. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Oh, I know that music.
He's got the lantern.
And he's not alone either. Ladies and gentlemen, anyway. The following contest is the main event of the evening, and it is scheduled for one fall. Currently on his way to the ring, being accompanied by Vela. He is from the Nevermore. This is the Rider of Death and a member of the Four Horsemen, the Pale Rider!
This guy is impressive, don't get me wrong, but where the fuck did he get that lantern?
He got it from the Shepherd.
He stole that. That's Shepherd's actual lantern, and he stole it.
Technically,
from him.
According to the Rider, the lantern was his first. He simply took it back, according to him.
So, this is a case of possession is 9/10 of the law.
Possibility, but at the same point, Shepard's argument is he could have collected any time, and he's been around for a long time, and he hasn't come to collect. But taking the lantern and taking Abigail away from him, it has really been screwing with Shepard's head. And that is a black raven on the screen. What in the hell are we even getting here?
I have no idea.
Ladies and gentlemen, being accompanied to the... What the hell is that?
If that word plate said right, that's the Shepherd.
Ladies and gentlemen, coming down the aisle, being accompanied by his right hand, Brody Harper, from Darkseid, this is... The Shepherd! There is something really off about this. I don't like this.
Hey, I got goosebumps on my arm the size of Edge Rock right now. I mean, look at that.
Shepherd warned the Rider if he did not get the lantern back that things were going to become very, very personal. You know what? That look on Rider's face, seeing Shepherd at the other side like this, and by the looks of it, oh my god, he's sick or not. Here he comes. JC's racing down here from the crowd.
Sure you should do that. I mean, you should be fucking relaxing right now.
Sick or not, he's coming out here.
Guys?
What the hell? What are you looking so freaked out over?
Do you not recognize that mask?
I can't see it with the lights out. What in the heck? Oh my god.
It's a purple mask.
Yeah, I know.
It's him.
What?
Get a good look at that mask, Texan. Or sorry, Jim, rather. That's gotta look familiar, at least in some way.
Did he summon the... did he summon Abomadon?
I don't think he summoned Abomadon. Remember, Abomadon and Shepard used to be a single entity. I honestly think wherever Abomadon was, as brain dead as he was, I think the Shepherd went and reclaimed what was originally his.
We're all fucked.
Oh my!
Even Vayla's looking. Even Vayla's looking scared.
That is Abomadon's mask.
Where did he get that?
Like I said, he must have been looking. He must have been looking for Abomadon and must have found where he was. On top of that, look at those scars all over Shepard too.
This is not good.
Whoa! No, they're bleeding purple. Shepard is daring the Rider to get back in the ring. Rider grabbing him by the hair. And oh my! What the hell?
Running ice cold.
What the hell is he doing? Oh no! Oh!
Reverse Alabama slam.
Hanging him over the ropes like that, too. Shepard really aggressive here. Really putting on the pressure here. I don't think the Rider understands what he's done. And if I remember correctly, When Shepard originally took the lantern from Ryder, they were a single entity. What is this gonna mean?
Fucked if I know, but I'm fucking creeped out.
Case of history repeating itself?
Good possibility. If Ryder's not careful, Shepard might take that lantern back after all. One. Only one. Brody backing off here, leaving it to Shepard. And here he comes again. He's not sizing up. I'll give him that. He's sizing the Rider up, but he's not attacking him.
This isn't good, guys.
If he did, he'd probably disqualify his master or something.
Oh my god! Chokeplex and Rider bounced off the LED screen.
He did that with Little Lee. You know what I mean.
Right. Oh my god. Uranagi!
Oh dear.
Familiar force with it too. Abomadon is the only other one that delivered it with the kind of force that Shepard just unleashed. And oh my god, Sister Abigail! One, two. Ryder kicks out. Shepard is literally losing his mind out here. Oh!
And the digital crowd is chanting fight forever.
Now that game's been released already.
No, that's waited forever. This is fight forever.
And Shepard is going after Ryder like literally this is the last stand. And stomps on that mask. I think he just yelled out towards Vayla. He did this to himself. Oh, falling senton did not connect.
You can hear Vayla back there. She's yelling at Shepard to stop.
I don't think Shepard has the capacity to stop now. Like I said, Ryder made it personal by taking away something that
another Sister Abigail
took one of the things that was very important to the Shepherd. One, two. And the Ryder kicks out again.
Ryder, for your own health, stay the fuck down.
Dude, he's the horseman of death. He's not gonna fucking listen.
Even if he did stay down. Oh my god! Did he just try
to snap his neck? And a bulldog.
Oh god! Gonna try for it, no!
Tried the hand of death, and Shepherd immediately countered.
These two are getting
really
brutal
here. Over a pin? This isn't gonna work.
Two.
And right on the second count.
Shepherd trying to get back to his feet. No avail on that one. Uh-oh. Oh! Oh! Full Nelson press. Nice shot. Vela again pleading with Shepherd to stop. And Shepherd caught in a bear hug.
Is he going to tap, snap, or nap?
Look at the bruising on his chest. Trying to hammer into the side of Ryder's head and getting himself loose.
And rang the bell.
And Vela telling the Ryder to get out of the ring. This isn't worth it. And Shepherd waiting in on the top rope and comes right down on top of her right in front of Vela. Headbutt.
And he twisted his body to make Vela see him do that.
He made sure of it, yeah. And now the Ryder kicked to the gut.
Wait, where'd Vela go?
She moved away. Oh no. Oh!
Powerbomb.
Up to five. Yeah, Vela's staying away from the action. And oh my god, Shepherd's body, the bruising all over him. Oh god, there it is!
Oh no. Hand of death.
One, two. And the Ryder kicked out.
No, he breaks out.
He thought he had him there. Oh, heavy clothesline.
One of his signatures.
Both of these two must be thinking, what the fuck do I have to do to put the other one away?
What the? Oh no.
What the? Oh no.
Holy shit.
Shepherd from behind here. Oh no.
Tombstone. Is that going to end it?
That might be it. One, two, three.
That's it.
Brody, get the lantern.
Remember what I said about Ryder making it personal.
Oh, damage God. These two took.
Here is your winner, the Shepherd.
Wait, did Brody grab the lantern and run? Because I don't see him here.
I don't see the lantern either, no, but I don't remember seeing Brody grabbing it either.
I think the Ryder might still have it.
If Vela...
He retreated as soon as the bell rung.
If the Ryder retreated, either he grabbed it or Vela grabbed it and took off. I don't think Vela would have grabbed
Vela's
it, though.
No, Vela's still at ringside. She's in shock.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you're still here, that means you made it to the end of our program, and the next time you'll be seeing us is, of course, tomorrow for Sunday in the Slaughterhouse. Might be a little bit later than our usual broadcast because I'll be visiting family. But nevertheless, ladies and gentlemen, if you're here tomorrow, we will hopefully have an update with what's going on here because, again, this can't be over. Especially if the Ryder got out of there with the lantern. That being said, ladies and gentlemen, for all of us here, I want to thank our special guest commentators for this evening from YWL and ACW, that being Jim Johnson and Bruce Northaway.
Yeah.
And, of course, JC the... Sorry, go ahead.
No, finish when you're done.
And, of course, JC the All-Star, who managed to come back despite feeling sick, managing to come back at least for the last match, for what it's worth.
Yeah, I would have been here sooner if not for that, but I am feeling a bit better, so.
No worries.
All right, you, back to bed and relax.
On top of that, ladies and gentlemen, we will see you tomorrow night for Sunday in the Slaughterhouse. Have a good evening, everybody.
Good night, everyone.
Be safe in the world, no matter where you happen to be.